Everybody, it's Cinnamon Cootie, your Art Sherpa, and today I'm going to show you how you can make this drizzle face, which is a really fun abstract face that beginners can do. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hi, guys.
He's finally caught his breath because it was his job to save a visitor to our studio. We had an unexpected visitor right before the live.
We did.
As some of you know, if you follow us on Facebook, and I just want to say that the little fledgling is returned home. Mm-hmm. After when very brave mommy bird attacked the heck out of John, she just let him know.
She was defending her nest.
She did. She did a good job. We were really proud of her. So she's back up. And yes, we do have an eye on Twix. We know exactly where Twix is.
Yep.
Twix thought the whole thing was very exciting and actually helped us find the baby bird. Because all morning I'm saying, John,
there's a baby.
Is there a bird in the studio? And he's like, no, it's an echo.
It's got to be the echo. Because like, I walked around the room and there's no bird in here.
Yeah.
Nope, baby bird.
I know. So today we're going to be covering string gel medium.
Mm-hmm.
Other products that are like this is tar gel by Golden Acrylic Colors. And there's a couple other processes, some other ideas if you can't get string gel where you live or it's not available to you or you're on a budget that I'm going to give you, including, believe it or not, a little pint of house paint has a similar enough dynamic to be workable. You're going to have to work fast, but it's workable.
Yeah.
Elmer's glue turned into an extraordinary disappointment. I guess if you just squeezed it out of the bottle. And I had another surprising alternative.
Ooh.
Uh-huh. Does a lot of the stuff string gel does. And yeah, you could just spatula this over a painting and seal it. It's crazy stuff. So this is what we're using today. Mostly because I've used up my tar gel. And these were done with a combination of the triple thick glaze or string gel or the tar gel. So what these are is these are a medium that have a really connected gooey viscosity. I love the word I'm using, viscosity, right? And they were developed by artists that wanted to do some of the abstract expressionist kind of brutalist work. Like an artist that you might think of that did work like this is Jackson Pollock.
Yeah.
And actually, tar gel was designed for, that was the product used in the movie about his life. So let's come over to our white canvas. You can do this in white or black, but I'm going to do this in white today. And I'm going to be kind of a cheaty McCheaterson. Couple of success tips that I want to say here is that the bigger your canvas, the more you have control over your results, interestingly enough. And I'm going to, you know, just give myself a nice little face shape in here. I'm going to give myself a little eye line where I know I'm going to put my eyes. And it's okay to have pencil marks on your white because you're going to be drizzling. So that's an interesting thing that you can absolutely have some pencil marks. I need to have a place where I'm going to put the shadow for my nose. And I'm going to come down a little bit and make sure that I have nice lips. And so really there isn't a lot of information. Whether the canvas is black, if you want it to be black, just, you know, paint it with black gesso first. And you'll make your tar gel with white. Tar gel is one of my very favorite abstract mediums.
Yeah.
I love this stuff. It does a lot of interesting things. It's really fascinating. If you're a multimedia artist, go out and get a jar of this and experiment with going across dry surfaces and wet surfaces. So if you have watercolor paper and you have tar gel, you would go across some of that media if it's wet and then some of it if it's dry, which is sort of an interesting kind of thing. I'm going to... Bits of gesso. Don't... one of my recommendations is I did not enjoy the impact of the gesso on the tar gel. I think it really, really reduced performance. I'm just sort of shading out the nose here. So I've done a little smile scoop, and I'm just talking about some nostrils here and some nostrils here. A lot of this is going to be so weird and drizzly, it doesn't even really matter. But you need to know where your shapes are. You can do your eyes closed or open. I've seen both. The canvases here are 11 by 14. They're so small, I'm going to say you may want to think about doing the lids maybe closed. Just because it's a little bit harder to get some detail. No, as an what?
Oh, no, so you made a little dip there on the inside of the eye there.
Yeah. So here I make this little line, and that sort of lets me know where I'm going to be putting my eyes. I am not doing my whole believe face. If you want the believe face traceable, we have that on our website.
Okay, so they can find that. They can find that up on our
or
website.
Or you can sketch in your believe face at any time.
Hmm.
Right. I'm gonna give myself some eyebrows. I'm gonna put them. I'm gonna line them up with the tear ducts today. So this is where my facial features are gonna be focused. You can make these bigger. You can make these smaller. It's really up to you when you're making one of these faces. This is live, so this could be an epic fail. This could be like the first Sherpa epic fail.
Yeah.
Because this is a really look. Here's the thing about string gel, especially this kind of abstract drizzle faces. It isn't a hoot.
Yeah.
You guys are probably asking, how many hoots is this? There's no hoot. And I don't want to say that there's succeed and fail. What I'll say is there's a fun experience that sometimes results in a painting you will love more than life itself. And sometimes results in a painting where you're like, huh, I learned a lot from that. And they're both valuable experiences. And they teach you a lot about what's important in a portrait, in the same way our scribble face did. What's important in the portrait? A lot of you guys took that idea and ran with it, and you were doing, you know, portraits of famous people and different people, and you can kind of see how relaxing like that lets you see things a little bit better. I like to throw different things at you because not everybody has that aha moment the same way. There isn't a formula for an aha moment. There's along the journey, each of you will have different aha moments, and those will come together and create the artist that you're going to be someday. So even if this isn't your aha moment, try to relax and have fun with it. All right, yeah. So how you mix up your string gel. Here is string gel. It's an effects texture gel and tells you some interesting things. It is a gel with a honey-like consistency, enhances depth of color, and increases transparency. It does all that. It's permanent, non-yellowing, flexible, and water-resistant when dry. Mix with acrylic color for interesting applications and effects. They're not kidding. Don't mix with oils. They're also not kidding. Gently pour to yield a long, consistent, flowing string of gel. And you can also brush on. The trick with this is that when you open it, you do need to wipe it, as it tends to be messy. And I'm gonna try to see if I can get a. Can you kind of see it pouring out?
Oh yeah, yeah.
All right, that's way more than I actually need for this piece. And see, the string is still going. I'm gonna take this string. It's non-toxic. It doesn't even have a Prop 65 warning on here, I don't think.
Mm-hmm.
So I haven't had any problems with it on my skin. The biggest problem is the lid sealing itself shut. And these lids should come with an aluminum foil seal that is not broken. Just so y'all know, where did my rags go?
Hmm.
Let me find a rag.
Shoot it down!
That's okay. I'm back.
Hey, you're back.
So you can kind of see what we're going for. This is a weird project. Yeah. I know, but I so appreciate you guys going for this. You guys have been so brave. And so open-hearted in your questing.
Mm-hmm.
And getting some really great results. Now, I have never worked at a high table like this with string gel. I like to work on a fairly low surface, so lots of gravity is employed. This is a gravity art. I have my ultimate varnish brush here, and I'm going to talk a little bit about finishing and varnishing when we're done. How do you finish this awesome painting? Your mini quest today... It's not going to take very much black. I've got this carbon black fluid.
Now, could you use any color?
You can. What I'm going to say is if you use a heavy body paint, mix a little of the string gel into it to improve its flowingness to flow it into this because it gets a little clumpy. It's a little clumpy. But look how little paint it takes to color all that.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't add water to it. Right, I'm just want to do this. This is going to be so messy. And the first method that you'll see artists use is they'll get a palette knife and they'll just drip this off. And you just go in. You just start coming in and you like start saying, all right, I've got an eye here. And you're going to start just dripping in your eye space. And this is a lot like how you do the pencil drawing, where you don't remove your pencil from the paper. Now, obviously, we're going to run out of gel.
Wow, that's really neat how it just kind of...
It just is. If you're doing pores,
yeah,
you have to wait. This is super critical. If you're one of my pouring artists, we'll cover this when we're talking about pouring paint. if you're doing a poured fluid medium, you have to wait to apply the string gel till after the pour has stabilized.
Right.
If you pour it in wet, it's got a very dense weight to it. It will sink to the bottom and create fissures. And so unless you intended to have fissures, which is sometimes fun, beyond crazing, these are fissures.
Wow.
So
yeah, I remember seeing some of those.
Yeah. So I'm just kind of, you know, it clumps and then it comes down and I'm like, oh, I just sometimes use the line to my advantage and just think about where I want lines. Tar gel or string gel or triple thick will do this. House paint runs a little fast, but it'll do it.
Hmm.
And so I'll just get some on the bead here, and then once I get the pour going, I can take it out. I'm just using this to maybe talk about the shapes and objects that I have here. Now, the other process you can do is kind of like, if you think of honey,
mm-hmm.
right, you can also use a spoon, which will give you a different type of control.
Yeah, that's a good question. Could you use one of those little honey...
Yes, you really can.
Oh, that would be really a good thing to use.
Yeah. So you just draw with your string.
Now, what about pouring this out? Is that
it does pour, but it's not an ideal pouring medium because it's too honey-like.
Okay, so you're better off to drizzle it.
Yeah. For the expense, what you can do if you're going to pour it is you can create a resin-like surface.
Yeah.
So if you really, really like resin work, but you can't work with resin, like I can't work with resin.
Mm-hmm.
So I can use this in exchange for that and seal a painting as if I sealed it in resin. But it's not in resin. Look, I'm just having fun. Have fun with it.
Yeah.
I let it wander around and tell me all kinds of stories. You can, you know, layer colors. You can absolutely layer colors. You can use this over paper. You can use this over any surface that would take acrylic paint.
Mm.
It is light, you know, it's all the things. It's flexible, so you can use it on canvas or hard, rigid boards.
Mm-hmm.
You can mix any colors or products that you want with it. You can alter its viscosity by adding, like, a polymer medium to it if you wanted to change it. So there's a lot of experimentation. It is not inexpensive. Thus, the triple thick gel alternative. And, you know, if you're only ever going to do this one time, you know, you could sit there and say, all right, well, I'm going to try some house paint.
House paint, huh?
Yeah. It's not going to give you this honey, but I think, you know, some of you guys have noticed that house paint will drizzle off something.
Yeah.
And that can be good. And it's fun to use it and tell your stories.
So now it's okay to there's a couple questions out here. Can you layer the colors?
Yes, I can demo that. I've got color and time.
Oh, that might be nice.
If you guys would like to see that, we can
definitely like.
John
to see
can
that.
Grab me any of my fluid paints.
Oop,
I have one more cup, so I could layer another color. You guys could, may even make some suggestions of a second color you might like to see on this.
Quinacridone is a.
We actually have quinacridone
in
fluid right
there's
now.
There's already questions about quinacridone. I've already seen them coming up here. Definitely.
So I have some fluid quinacridone pigment.
Okay.
See how you can actually be quite delicate with it. I'm being very abstract and you can get little drops. It's fun stuff. And you're just, you're like, sometimes it's nice to drop off in the cup and then hit your piece. Just saying. And where you end up getting structure in the subject is where you weight the lines, like with anything else. So you can kind of see a face is already revealing itself. Oh, hey, I will grab a quinacridone. And I've ordered some more string gel, so I don't have to worry. I'm string gel wealthy. You're like, it's over here. And yet I do not see the little tubs over here. No, it's okay. I think they are all over there. Let's have them pick between the teal and the quinacridone. The teal is really nice and they might like it. That teal. Okay, you're just grabbing all these other colors that are non-teal. All right, I got black on the bottom. So here, guys, here's a teal, and I'm thinking you guys might really enjoy this, but we do have quinacridone. It is quite... It's quite dark, though, so you might it may not show up or pop on the piece the way you're looking. I've gotten some string gel on the bottom of the cup, but it's not important. And this time I'll put in the pigment first. I'm going to use about that much. And I'll make a little batch of gel up. And this one I'll do with just the palette knife.
Okay.
So I'm going to pour some more in. Fun always to do. You can do smaller amounts. That's okay. This jar, if you really plan your project, will do several paintings.
Yeah.
So don't feel like you can't. And you rinse your tools off in water. Absolutely.
So while you're doing that, can I oop, there goes the Sherpa going down. So I have some questions for you.
Just hit my head again.
Oh, no.
It's the baby bird. It like the whole like nature in the studio always throws you just a little bit. See, look at that go.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that fun? It's just stirring. You can just really see that go.
Avalon would like to know, how long does string gel take to dry completely?
So on string gel... definitely always read the website, but what I'm going to say is I personally, to allow something like this to cure, to allow pores to cure or any heavy impasto mediums to cure, give it a couple weeks.
Okay.
You know, you're not going to get so much dust and dirt on your painting in that time.
Now, there's another question here. What can you add to thicken it? Can you add glue or flour or...
No, don't add glue or flour. In fact, don't add PVA glue or Mod Podge or anything like that.
Hmm.
You void the warranty of your paint.
Oh, interesting.
So say you were doing a painting, right? And you use the paint as is described by the manufacturer. Believe it or not, there's kind of an implied guarantee of performance. But if you add a bunch of crazy stuff to your paint, as artists are wont to, right? Because that's our job, to be imaginative and exploratory. It can also cause you to lose the warranty on your paint. So it's harder to go to that company and say, hey, you know, all my paint fell off the canvas and my collector bought it. And that's very sad. And they're sad and I'm sad. We're all so sad. You know what I mean? You would have no restitution.
Oh, man.
Sorry, I'm being really weird here.
That looks great.
It's fun. And you could just keep going and going and going. You can see that the knife offloads the gel a little differently than the spoon. So I just wrap it there, do the honey wrap, allow the drop to come off in the cup, and then come over and explore. The lesson of this art, the lesson of this type of abstract work, and listen, this is figurative abstract, right? You can tell it's a face. But this stuff is fantastic for free-spirited, emotionally extracted abstracts. This is really beautiful stuff where you can sit in your studio and literally spend hours, right? Literally spend hours just stringing out gel layer on layer on layer on layer. It is super fun stuff. But you can see how where it goes into its own.
Oh, yeah.
It blends in, but it holds its body on the surface of the white canvas.
Yeah, you can really see it where it kind of does it there on the nose.
Yeah.
Or kind of overlaps.
Which is why kind of went into that a little bit more. And then that's I can really layer cool. The black on top of this. I can layer this till this is solid. I could let the canvas show through and my pencil marks show through. I can let this go until, you know, the canvas is a solid mass of strings. There's no wrong here. Your goal as a new artist is to look at these things and say, how does this impact me creatively? Does this free me up? Mm-hmm. Does this help me tap into something that's maybe been a little inaccessible to me? Because if it does, then it's just doing its job. Because, you know, I mean, there's the goal of the painting, which it's really fun to have a fun painting. These get really beautiful when they get big.
Yeah.
And again, it's abstract. It's not like you're going to really do it wrong. Don't tell any abstract artists I said that. But it's true. I mean, you need design and line and form and stuff. But really, this is about you painting feelings more than objects.
Yeah.
And so you can really play with this.
So
as you want to.
Now
I'm liking that. Just very, very mellow and silly. And
you can find out more about this and all about all of the other projects, right, on theartsherpa.com.
Yes, you can.
And we've got you can use the traceables are available up there at the big on the Big Art Quest pages.
So you can, yeah, if you're just like, I can do all of this but draw the face, well, we got a traceable for that. But, you know, feel like you could also just take a canvas, paint it a solid color.
Mm-hmm.
Black, I would highly recommend black with bright colors. You know, it's a good base. And just drizzle until you feel better. This is a real until you feel better art practice.
Yeah, I know we're... Looks like we're
about
done.
We're pretty much done.
Let me ask you one more question here before
any,
we go.
Any questions? It's a good time. Hit me with all the questions you guys have about tar gel and string gel.
Yeah. So
tar gel, string gel. And remember an interesting and surprise alternative.
That was one of the questions was, is you could use that triple thick. Okay.
I did. There's a bunch of triple thick in here.
Cool. Okay. And the last overwhelming question here was, is there a difference in the varnishing process?
Yeah. So here's how it goes. I can probably varnish this with my ultimate varnish brush, right, and a brush on varnish if I wasn't trying to preserve pencil. But let's say artistically you put in a bunch of pencil marks you wanted to hold, right? Or you weren't sure about, like, you know, catching, like, thick varnish. I would probably use something like this and spray it twice.
Mm-hmm.
Right, as is instructed, not like back to back, because that'll cloud. Like, spray it, allow it to dry, do what the manufacturer says, spray it again, allow it to dry, and then decide what finish you want. If you want it to be matte, then you would do a matte finish. If you want it to be semi-gloss, then you do the semi-gloss finish. But remember, when you're varnishing, to do two coats of gloss.
Yeah.
Whether it's brush on, whether it's spray on, before.
That's great.
Before you finish the varnish, or your matte varnish gets too cloudy. It's a real problem. I'm just drizzling. So, see how that's just fun? It's like this happy little line. Happy little... I know this is a weird project, guys, but it's an under-talked about medium. I'll probably do like a little short video about this is string gel, how to use it.
String gel.
String gel. String gel. Super fun stuff, string gel. Super fun stuff, tar gel. I mean, we all have preferences. I would definitely say the honey thing in a spoon is my favorite tool of dispersal. I don't like the palette knife method as much.
Yeah, that seems to hold more and allow you to kind of drip
it lets
it
me
off.
Get a better string, effect. And now I'm kind of completing the painting. Can you see how I'm kind of... You see how I'm completing the painting? Also, we could be totally done by now, but I'm enjoying talking to you all, and I'm enjoying the...
It's a nice day. You know, we had a little bird visit in the studio today. We have had... We were starting our days a little earlier, you know. So it's nice to see the morning stuff.
When you move faster, it does these weird sort of like... It's more likely to break, but you get these weird pulled lines.
Yeah, they look really interesting.
Yeah. You actually have more control than you think. And again, bigger canvases will give you more control over the results.
Now, this is an interesting question. Can you use slow dry with this?
I wouldn't.
I don't know why you would, but I, you know.
I really, really would not. I, you know, if you've got, I, so here's the thing. What would your reason for using slow dry be?
I don't.
You're not blending.
Yeah, probably not needed.
It would make the paint do all the opposite of what it's meant to do. And honestly, you need this. It's already drying slow.
So.
It's
all right.
Sticky. It's like painting with honey. So you're not going to get a blend out of it. So keeping it wet longer does what?
Extends it.
Yeah.
It's really great.
And it's another one of those good things if, you know, it would be hard to be, like, really seated and do this. It's definitely, you want to have some elevation when you're doing it.
Mm.
I feel like I didn't do this eyebrow. That may be true. That may not be true. I'm just feeling like it didn't get done.
You're just enjoying playing with your paint.
I kind of, at this point, am just sort of enjoying playing with my paint. It's fun, and I have all of this stuff. If you get the condiment cups with the lids,
yeah,
then you can keep it wet for a long time. I'm just trying to.
Now that's amazing.
I'm just having fun with it. Makes a face.
Makes a face.
Makes a face. Make a face.
Enjoy and you can life. Make a face at home too.
Yes. With just a happy, like, weird, scribbly little face.
And so anybody, this is a definite little brush attempt.
Yes. So full disclosure, I do this with my little brushes, but I get that string gels may be expensive for that. So alternatives for kids is to dye your, and this is the only case I'm going to say use PVA glue, would be to put a pigment in your PVA glue and let them squeeze it out of that. And scribble with it. If you want them to have the tar effect for a sensory experience, then I would definitely say go get the string gel, which is why we do.
Gotcha.
Because we like it. And they really love the impact of seeing how it gloppies.
Okay. So that's really neat. That brings up another interesting question here in chat. So if you were just wanting to experiment with this, and you could just get your glue, your PVA glue out and squeeze it out, huh?
Yeah, you could get it. You can absolutely do that.
It's just not archival.
No.
But it is valid for.
No, it's like if you use it as a pouring medium, you know, then your paint's susceptible to moisture forever. It's why you don't want to use Mod Podge.
But if you used only glue on.
If you're not looking to have the piece last, right, like a long, long, long time, it's fine.
Just, yeah.
You know, just don't sell it to anybody.
But as a student working material, it might be a way to experiment with a concept.
It's a way to experiment with a concept. And if I was working with a classroom of kids, it might be the way that I would go.
Hmm.
But it won't do this dripping effect. It'll have to be from the tube.
Right, yeah. You're not going to get this really neat, stringy, different thickness scribbly effect.
No.
It's like, this has really cool viscosity.
But they can scribble.
But you could, yeah.
But keep in mind, we actually took, when my daughter was in kindergarten, we took a giant canvas down there and we had it primed all black. And then we had the kids write words of power, things that made them feel empowered, on the canvas. And then we gave them string gels and things to splatter. And then they like actually did the string gel and all the stuff. And then we varnished it over.
Yeah.
And it was a really beautiful piece of work.
Yeah.
It was gorgeous canvas. Gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. And the kids really enjoyed it. Kids always enjoy working with amazing art materials. I think one of the gifts that my mom gave me is that I always had good pastels, I always had good paper, good paint, good everything. And that was something that was in my life. And I'm really grateful to this day for that. Because it was a real pleasure. So I appreciated that. I think my kids probably would come away with, like, I had a lot. My daughter says, well, we're an artist house to her friends. We're an artist house.
We have a lot of art.
It's a little bit hot in here.
Well,
darling's babies, it's so hot. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little trip, this little divergence. You know, we're going to keep talking about abstraction and faces. We're going to keep talking about faces, and we're just going to keep drilling down, and we're going to keep touching different things till each of you have your aha moment, because that's what we're looking for, is you to go, ah,
yeah,
I got it. It's just, yes.
And you can find Eureka. This. Yep. And you can find this and all of our other information, sorry, you know, at theartsherpa.com. We get up at early in the morning, so we're both a little, like, caffeinated, I think, today.
I think so. And like, also with the baby bird.
The baby bird through our thing.
Be good to yourselves. Make time to play in your art And I want to see you at the easel really soon. Also, be good to each other.
Yes. Love you guys. Bye.